Super excited to show you the Bronco. It turned out absolutely awesome. Now, in this video, I'm not going to go absolutely step by step, but I'm going to hit every one of the highlights to show you how I put this model together and how easy it really was, even for a beginner. It does take a little bit of time, but when you spend a little bit more time on details, it pays huge dividends in the end. So let's get started. I'm going to use what I call the block method and just go to my create menu and create a rectangle. And then it lets me go straight in and pull that rectangle out. I like this method because it gives me a good general reference, the size I want my end model. This one's 1 foot by 6 inches. So I just grab a canvas and I put it up against the side of my block. Then I put a sketch up against the side of my block. Remember, sketches need a plane to work off of. So I'm not using the canvas as a plane, I'm using the side of the block. Two things to remember when you're tracing out geometry inside of Sketch: don't ever do things twice. So the hinges, once I made one hinge, I just highlighted the whole thing, cut, copy, paste, and then I created another one. Also, for common geometry, like some of the patterns I'm finding, remember to use offset. That way you know that line that you just created will look exactly like the other line right next to it. Now, you don't have to project and include to get that outside box shape. Remember, you just need a rectangle or something that's bigger than the sketch itself. That way you can grab the outside edge and it gives you something to push-pull across your block. I did the same thing here, but I actually forgot to cut the other half, so I just created an extra shape here that enables me to cut straight down the middle to make sure I have just one half of my model to work with, because it's going to be symmetric on the other side. I'm pulling that geometry off my sketch to get those details in the front of my truck, the grill and the bumper, those types of things. So catching all that geometry. Now I'm simply cutting out the wheel wells, and I'm just going to eyeball it at this point because I can always adjust this geometry later. Now the front bumper, a little bit dicey because even though I caught it from the side, it doesn't go all the way across. So I use my sketch, and then this time when I push pull, I do intersect. That gives me just the part of the bumper that I want, and then it gives it the bumper that's actually there in the actual model. There are 100 different ways to do things. When I caught this geometry originally, this was actually just the fenders. It doesn't go all the way down the side of the truck, and I realized that. And instead of just creating fenders by push-pull and creating, I just was like, okay, well, I'll just split my entire body and then cut the fenders out of that portion. This is a great example of what looks to be tricky geometry that's actually super easy to catch. You catch it from the side profile, push it over into the middle of the model, and then adjust it, and it works out perfectly. I actually used a couple of different methods and I tried a couple of different things. All I wanted was an outline of a door. After experimenting around, I actually found this is actually the easiest way to do it. You just create a double outline by using offset of your original lines and try to keep it the same all the way across and around your door, and then just cut out the outline very, very shallowly. Now I'm just going in and tweaking geometry. Things like fenders and things that look differently from the side than they really are from the front, you got to go in and kind of fix manually. So that's what I'm kind of doing. I'm fixing some tricky geometry, and when things don't work correctly, I just start deleting faces and pushing objects into, or faces into each other. And if it's the same body, they'll simply combine. So pretty easy trick there. For the rest, same thing. I use my canvas. Then I put a sketch on top of my canvas, then I cut that geometry out, and then I adjust that geometry to the way I want it. We'll be right back. I always use a vector program. I'm using CorelDRAW to do text. Then I convert it into a vector and then bring it in. So that's what I did for the Bronco on the front of the grill. It's just too hard to fight Fusion because it's not that good at vectors. So I just do it in an outside program, then bring it in. Now, there is a little trick here. Aligning text in Fusion 360 can be a little tricky. I found a couple of easy tricks. One of them is to create a center point inside of your sketch. And if you need to create a line all the way across to find that center point, then do it. Then from there, grab that point, hit the align tool, and then align it to the center of the face you're trying to cut into. I didn't like the wheels on the original canvas that I had, so I went out and found another picture, but I had to make sure the picture was the correct size. So I put it up against the back, aligned it, make sure it looked correct. Then I laid that canvas down flat because it's easier to make tires flat on the flat plane. So that's just kind of the way I do it. I told you tires are really actually pretty easy. The cool part here is I want to show you that knobby tires are actually really easy too. Just find the center point, create a rectangle to cut out, and then repeat that pattern underneath the sketch menu. You've got circular pattern, and it's pretty easy and self-explanatory. I did use a trick here that's worth mentioning. I went up to my select menu and made sure it selected just faces. That way I didn't have to click every single tiny one of those little faces. So I just grabbed them all and then I unselected the ones that I didn't want. So that was an easy way to get through that. Now I just cut a knobby pattern all the way out of my tire. And you'll see that from there, all you really need to do is cut it a few more times and then kind of mishmash those pieces together, and it gives you a fantastic knobby tire. I love how hard things actually end up being super easy, what you think would be hard. To get a knobby tire, all you really have to do is cut it into a few pieces and then twist each one of those pieces and put it back together. And it gives you a perfect, cool knobby pattern for a tire. So great trick there. Don't be afraid to keep making new sketches and new sketches. You can always go back and delete them, and I'm never afraid to delete an old sketch because they're easy to project from any geometry. Now I'm just going in and creating the hub inside of the wheel, and then I'm going to use that circular pattern tool again. I need to find the center, and then once I find that center, I create a hexagon, and then I use that circular pattern tool again, which is super easy. Then I pull out all those little hexagons, and they look like lug nuts. It looks awesome. One of the greatest things about 3D modeling is you don't have to do things twice. I took that chassis that I built for my last model and I just pulled it over into this model. So I saved it. All I have to do is resize it, tweak it a little bit, and it'll work great. And then that way I don't have to spend all that time rebuilding that little chassis portion just for the bottom of my model. Now all I'm doing is, once I use that old geometry and that old piece from my last model, you've got to go in and tweak and make sure every single thing fits correctly. But it's pretty easy. I just zoom in, zoom out, you know, figure out where it's going to rub, where it's not going to rub, and then I make sure I resize it to fit this model. So from this point, you can kind of just sit back and enjoy. I'm just going to go through really fast, and I'm going to, you know, mirror those objects that need to be mirrored, and then I'm going to go in, build some rearview mirrors, and build some more details like windshield wipers and things like that. Those things are super easy to forget, and when you go to finish your model, you're like, wait, something doesn't look right. So it's easy to like forget rearview mirrors and windshield wipers and things like that. But of course, they're super easy to do. The only thing to kind of notice here is during the windshield wiper, when I was building those, I couldn't see them behind some of the geometry. So remember, you can always split sketch, which allows you to just see that surface, and it cuts the rest of the model out of the way. So I had to do that so I could see these windshield wipers to get those to work. Last but not least, I just go in, split my model apart. Of course, I copy it first and then get it ready for 3D printing by making sure that all those printing surfaces are flat and on the same plane, so it's pretty easy. So I hope you enjoyed this video. This model and most of my models are available on Thingiverse and my website. I will post links down in the description. And if you got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.